For a car or not?
Yeah, got.
You don't.
Got right.
AMD is sitting comfortably in the driver's seat when it comes to CPU, it looks like they have their eyes on Intel. According to Wannasmith, best known for his clock tuner for Ryzen software, which you can check out by the way if you want more performance out of your Ryzen CPU, he found some hidden information in AMD's latest Agisa firmware on the upcoming Zen 3 CPUs. According to the firmware, there will be a 10-core CPU coming from AMD's Zen 3 lineup. Right now, AMD only offers quad-core, 6-core, 8-core, 12-core, and 16-core. While we are unsure how AMD will shape their upcoming lineup, it looks like this 10-core CPU will face against directly to Intel's flagship 10-core CPU, which is the i9-10900K. Other than that, Wannasmith also discovered a new curve optimizer which will be coming with Zen 3. This feature allows you to configure the boost curve of Ryzen CPUs. Whoa, it looks like we'll finally be able to tweak the per-core clock speeds without any restrictions. Whoa, AMD, we will be waiting. Year after year, we have seen and heard many gimmicks that are supposed to make phone cameras smarter and perform better in low-light situations. Well, because there's a limitation to the sensor size in order to put into the smartphone, companies have to be smarter with their implementation. Well, word has it that Vivo is developing its own image sensor which uses an RGBW color filter that apparently collects 160% more light than a conventional RGB-equipped sensor. When compared to RYYB sensors that Huawei uses, Vivo's new color filter can capture 15% more light and is not prone to color casting issues. As the sensor is still under development, Vivo will only be able to incorporate this sensor into their devices next year. Or is this another gimmick? Only time will tell. Are you guys an avid Smule, the singing app user? Well, good news to you because you'll soon be able to sing karaoke on Spotify. This news came from Spotify right after Twitch Sings announced that they'll be shut down in 2021. Spotify's karaoke mode will allow users to adjust the vocals of the songs they're listening to. And on top of that, with the lyrics mode, will users be having a super legit karaoke experience? What do you think about this feature, leh? For me personally, I don't think I'll be using it unless I can upload my singing, my sweet singing onto my Spotify profile, which is kind of like Tencent's WeSing app. Wouldn't that be more engaging for users? But if you are the shy type, just go to YouTube and look for the karaoke instrumental version of the song. Although I think it is a pretty good start for Spotify to expand into a more entertaining app rather than just a music player, but I'll comment on it more after it is fully released. Because like I said, there are plenty of apps out there that can give you that awesome, so fulfilling karaoke experience. So Spotify, if you cannot beat them, then why you? If you play Minecraft on PS4, check this out, because very soon you'll be able to enjoy the game on PlayStation VR at no extra cost. Actually, a VR version of the game is already available on many VR platforms like Oculus Rift and Samsung VR gear. So I guess it is kind of late for it to arrive onto PSVR, right? But I guess it is better than nothing, lah. The developer of Minecraft, Mojang Studios, promised players that a VR version will be 100% similar to the game, wholesome and pure full-fledged Minecraft. There will be two modes available too, immersive and living room. The developer never really go into details of these two modes, but I'm guessing immersive is like IMAX experience, while living room is like Netflix and chill at home. Anyway, the upgrade will come as a patch that is free to download for everyone. All you need is to purchase the game and to purchase a PS4 and to purchase PS4 VR and also prepare some Dramamine in case you puke over your living room.
Google Disney's live action remake of Mulan and you'll be bombarded with bad reviews and bad news. But why are so many people Dulan with Mulan? Even though the director Nikki Caro has done plenty of research before this, it seems as though they have underestimated their homework. Blogger Nusantara Naga has highlighted this confusing symbolism of the phoenix, which in Western culture stands for rebirth, renewal, or reincarnation in flames, to show off Mulan's character development. They took the saying, phoenix rising from the ashes, literally. Wait, where have I seen this before? Oh yeah! But in Chinese culture, the phoenix, aka Feng Huang, symbolizes the union between yin and yang, which basically refers to a blissful relationship between husband and wife. So what? Was Mulan supposed to marry Jet Li, who played the cake? Oh, of course that didn't happen because they went with the Western symbolism of what the phoenix is. Oh, they also turned Mulan into a witch because she has the power of qi. So now what? All the aunties and uncles practicing qigong in the park are practicing witchcraft, is it? Hello? Excuse me? With Mulan headlining the news for political reasons, is the movie's profits gonna dry up from the constant hot fire? Moving on to the comment section. Nitikon Chien said, what if MLM has always been hosted by someone else with Michelle deepfake onto it?
Maybe we should try that, right?
Are you real? Blink, blink. Next off, Jin Jun Woo said, Shane must be a proud dad. Is he?
See, this father make us start again.
Because you all always fight. And so slave. I make sure that you two have to like get along.
For real, your production quality is too good. It's the YouTube algorithm doing that's not getting you more subs and views.
Yeah, YouTube. What are you doing?
Huh? Because y'all never share our video, right?
It's time to do something about it.
NVIDIA broadcast is legit awesome. Linus did a review on the noise cancellation and it worked really
well. Oh, I saw the video. Did you see the video? It's crazy one.
Yeah, I saw also. Then crazy
one. Then they run until the got like wet, like the what do you call that? The
that you had you could
blow dryer so can disappear on the sound.
Really?
Yeah. Next time you stream,
hey,
right?
Hey, next time, right? Next time you stream, right? I put next to you, right?
And then?
Can I hear you? And then I can focus on my work.
Then you can
says the person that every 5 minutes, Shane, can I even do my thing properly? You know why? Because you're pointing.
I'm a raccoon!
Okay, Muhammad Arif Chemist. Should we buy RTX 20 series now at discounted price or wait for Ampere?
Here's the thing. Even if you upgrade to Ampere and you don't have money to buy a new monitor, you still can't get anything, right?
So how?
So you need to have budget for the monitor as well if you're going to upgrade your GPU. So, Xiao Jerry say, RTX 30 GPU is going to set a very high bar. Hopefully no shortage of supply and also don't get bombed by cryptocurrency junkies. Here's the thing, there's definitely going to be a shortage with every new release. The first 6 months, you can't not be able to buy anything. So if you really need a GPU right now, just buy a 20 series at a discount. If you really need to wait, then you wait lah. If you cannot wait, right, then you be bangsawan like me. You can buy the 3090 and 3080 one. 7,000 ima, cheap.
Bye.
Time to deepfake Shane singing Unravel. Cannot copyright Gifford Chi say. Should I sell my RTX 2070 Super for a 3080? You sell now lah. But if no stock, then you must like 3-4 months don't have graphic card to use. Let me take some time to highlight Putz doing the Epi Days. And also Hawk come in and do the CSGO
tips.
It was actually Michelle's idea to bring in Hawk to do all these things. Kind of cool because she used to be from the CSGO scene. So we are very proud of these two babies for thinking out of content for us to do. So if you guys want to see any more type of content, just leave a comment down below. Let us know. Leave more comment. Comments like, Michelle is so pretty, Pat is so cute, so unhelpful. Just let us know what you want to see. Harms are confirmed, cannot. Okay, I'll see you guys.
In the next one.
Shane!